question people used to ask a lot was, where were you when the clones attacked? The answer in my case was shambling my way out the front door of a cantina on Coruscant. I can't remember the name of it, but I was thoroughly intoxicated. I was on shore leave, you see, and celebrating my promotion to the rank of captain by having one last crawl across the capital with the crew. The sun was just coming up, and I remember blinking furiously, dazzled by the morning light. Eventually, when my eyes and my general sense of balance had readjusted a bit, I noticed a small crowd beginning to gather around a nearby hollow emitter in the street. Usually those things just broadcast public service announcements and, you know, one of the news channels on repeat. Most people didn't pay any attention because, frankly, the news at the time was always pretty grim. So, as you can imagine then, my curiosity was piqued merely by the fact that there was a crowd at all. Then I saw the images. It was all coming from Geonosis. You could see formations of clones running across the red dunes, led by Jedi Knights parrying incoming blaster bolts. Towering over them were these huge walkers, and the sky above was practically blotted out by assault ships. I mean, the news that we were at war would have been enough of a shock, but this new clone army? That was something else. Entirely by accident, I think I found myself standing next to one of my fellow lieutenants. He looked from the holonet, and then back to me, without saying a word. I don't think any of us really knew what to say. Although, in reply, I think I recall slurring something along the lines of, "Well, they kept that quiet, didn't they?" before I vomited all over his shoes. A little less than a month later, I found myself on the command deck of the Eternal Vigilance, my first command, one of the new Acclimator assault ships. Ostensibly a military transport, the Acclimator-class Transgalactic Military Transport Ship, to use its full title, was in reality the first of a whole line of vessels that would one day lead to the Imperial Star Destroyers we all know so well. It was a good, sturdy vessel, armoured with neutronium and equipped with enough turbo lasers to throw some good punches in ship-to-ship combat while still managing to carry a full legion of clone troopers along with their supplies and vehicles and aircraft. Even back then, though, there was something oddly oppressive about the things. Those grey interiors, completely drained of colour. All those identical corridors. I'm not too ashamed to admit that I got lost on my own starship a few times at the beginning. When I got my promotion, none of this was what I expected. I'd graduated from being the first officer on a Corellian corvette hunting pirates to commanding a warship in one of the greatest conflicts the galaxy had ever seen. It didn't take long to see why, when it became clear that the war was going to last much longer than that first battle on Geonosis. The Republic needed more ships, more crews, and more officers. Officers like me, with some experience, however little that might be. It would have been years before I'd got my own captaincy in peacetime, but there I was, staring out the window at the rest of the fleet, in my shiny new uniform, hands clasped behind my back, trying to look as dignified as possible. I was about to head into a trial by fire. All of us were. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Empire at War mega campaign that I've been talking about on the channel for a while. What is the plan for the mega campaign? Well, we're going to play Star Wars Empire at War with a bunch of mods, and we're going to play it right through the Star Wars timeline, basically, at least the old Legends one, I suppose. So the Clone Wars, through to the Galactic Civil War, through to the New Republic and the stuff after that. Should be good fun! If you're new to the game completely, which you might be, Empire at War is a pretty old real-time strategy game, which is obviously a Star Wars one, created by Petroglyph, I believe, back in the day. I don't remember the actual year it came out. I have to check the wiki for that. But it was pretty good. It was alright for its day. But what's really given this game a new lease of life lately has been the utterly brilliant modding community that has come along and just absolutely transformed this game from a decent Star Wars RTS to a game that has occupied a heck of a lot of my free time lately, I don't mind saying. I've been really, really impressed with it. So as I said, we're going to play right through the whole Star Wars kind of timeline here with various mods. And the first one here is Fall of the Republic. Well, Empire at War Expanded Fall of the Republic, which, as you could probably tell just by looking at it, covers the Clone Wars. So, I will do my best to explain our way through this for the perspective of someone who might be coming to this fairly fresh and new. I have streamed this plenty of times on Twitch before, and you know, I've put the VODs for those streams on YouTube as well, so if you want more Empire at War stuff, I've got a bunch of videos for a different mod, Awakening of the Rebellion, on the channel that you can check out if you like, if you want to see more. But today it's going to be Fall of the Republic as we begin the saga of this mega campaign. I possibly don't quite realize what I'm letting myself in for here. I could be playing this series for a long time. but it should be fun. Let's do it. So, single player is what we want. We want to do a galactic conquest, as we do. And we're actually, I think I'm going to do the small version of the Clone Wars here, which has 70 planets. That's still quite a lot, really. Main reason being, we could go bigger. We could go like the medium one with 95 planets. The larger you go, the higher the CPU load goes. And this game, because it's an old one, it's not terrifically well optimized. It's from that awkward era of video games where like they didn't all have multi-core support yet. And this is one of those, so if your single core performance of your CPU is not very good, which mine isn't very good either really right now, I've just noticed that the Steam notification popping up in the bottom right. I'm going to have to fix that in a second. I swear I turned those off, because I think they'll show up on the video because I'm recording in desktop mode right now. But anyway, you don't need to know about that. But yes, basically, performance is actually an issue with this game. I mean, I'm not surprised. The mods are trying to do a heck of a lot with a very old game right now. Like, the original vanilla Empire at War is an ugly, ugly game compared to how beautiful it looks nowadays with mods. And this one in particular is a very, very pretty mod, I think, anyway. So, yeah, I think we're going to go with the small one. Not to mention the fact that we're also going to be moving on to other mods in this series after we finish with this one. So I think we'll keep it to the small one. 70 planets, eras 2 to 4, playable factions of the Republic and the CIS, the Separatists. CPU loads apparently medium. Play through the Clone Wars between the CIS and the Republic with no outside factions. I believe it says that for all of them because they've not actually implemented any outside factions yet. I'm playing the 1.0 version of this mod. It just came out a few weeks ago. So there are no additional factions in it yet, but I think there are plans to add some in the future. This mod is a constantly in development thing. In fact, most of them are. They're all very actively supported, which is lovely. So we're going to go for that. I'm going to play on difficulty. Admiral or Captain? Let's go with Admiral. Why not? Let's go with Admiral difficulty. What? I may regret this decision, but we'll give it a go. I'm pretty sure I can adjust this difficulty mid-campaign if I want to. So, now the faction up there, it says Commerce Guild. And it does say no outside factions there, but it's kind of telling a porky pie there slightly, and you'll see what I mean when I get into it. But we can't play as the Commerce Guild up there. We can actually only pick the Confederacy or the Galactic Republic. And we will be playing as the Galactic Republic in this one. As the intro for this video hopefully would have made very obvious. I hope you liked that, by the way, because that took a really long time to make. You'd think making a bunch of text scroll up the screen like the start of a Star Wars movie would be pretty easy, but no, if you were to recreate that and you want to make it actually look properly done, like in the actual films, it takes ages. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed that. There will be more of those as for each video as we go on through the series. It's sort of, I'm kind of vaguely inspired by the 501st Clone Legion War Journal things from the old Star Wars Battlefront 2 campaign. I don't know if any of you watching this played Battlefront 2 back in the day, but every time you started a mission, you got a cool intro story cutscene narrated by Tamwera Morrison, or whatever his name is, the guy who played all the clones in the movies. And I was kind of going for something similar to that, really. Anyway, I should probably shut up and get on with it. All right, starting era. We can actually pick a starting era in this. This is not a vanilla feature. This is a mod thing. So what this does, basically, is you choose the level of technology and the positions on the galactic map, depending on what era you pick. Now, era one, we can't go with that. That's actually pre-Clone Wars tech. And in this particular campaign that we've chosen to play here, that doesn't do anything, tech level one. We can start at tech level two. And era level two, which is what I intend to do. So we play through the whole sort of gamut of the tech tree in the Clone Wars experience. But you can start like at the end if you want to. That's totally a thing you can do. Yeah, that's all there is to mention for now. This is going to be very wordy, me explaining a lot kind of opening episode of this series, I'm afraid, folks. So if you're already familiar with the game and familiar with the mod, I apologize. I'm probably going to be over explaining a lot of things. So let's go. All right. Now you got to give it a minute here because some scripts are running in the background, I believe, that will sort out a lot of the background stuff, like all the planets and things, as you can see. Boom! And Palpatine's talking at us, and he's basically telling us that the Republic is now at war as a result of the events of the film of Attack of the Clones. And actually, in terms of when this mod actually kicks off, I believe it is some vaguely defined date a little bit after this episode 2 of the movie, so Attack of the Clones, basically. Sort of a start of the Clone Wars TV series, that kind of point in time. Mostly because if you look down here, you can see Geonosis is controlled by the Separatists because it's in blue. So they've already taken that back off the Republic at this point. And I believe Anakin is over here. And he has his long hair and he's got his robot arm attached. So clearly some time has passed since the end of Attack of the Clones. Right. I've got it paused at the minute. This is the interesting thing about this is this game's a bit like a Total War game, really. Actually, you've got a big strategic map, and then you have real-time tactical battles. But the interesting thing about this is that the strategic map here is also in real time, which is why I've got it paused right now, so I can talk without being interrupted by stuff. But as you can see, it's the galaxy in Star Wars. All the various bits in it, and there are some other factions. So you've got us here in red with the Republic. You got the Separatists in blue, and then we've got some other factions. I believe we've got the Trade Federation in white. We've got the Republic-aligned sector forces in dark red. So they're on our side, but they're not directly controlled by us for now. Up here, we've got in turquoise. We've got the Commerce Guild. And I think there's a couple of others around here somewhere. I don't know if they're necessarily in the campaign I've picked, though, because of the small size of it. Yep, there's the Techno Union in sort of brown color. And I think that might be the lot. What was the other big faction that was part of the Separatists? It was like the Banking Clan or something. I don't know if they actually show up in the campaign on this, though. That's in gray. What's that? That's just Independent Forces, okay, on Dathomir there. Alright. Okay, so our stuff is kind of spread out all over the place at the moment. You've got the core worlds in the middle here. So we've got Coruscant with Pharos right next to it, which is currently controlled by the Techno Union. Now, all these other factions, they're actually aligned with the Separatists. So we will be fighting them as well. And you can see they're aligned with the Separatists because they've got a little Separatist logo next to them. And the Separatists can actually move through these territories freely to get to me if they want to. And as the campaign goes on, these little mini factions can be incorporated into the big Separatist alliance as the faction grows and gets bigger. Just like these Republic sector forces here, same deal with us. As the campaign goes on, we can add them to our faction, basically. So, yeah, there's Coruscant right there, dangerously close to Forost, which is controlled by the what are they again? Sorry? The Techno Union, right? The brown guys, yeah. Anaxes, Chandrilla, Alderaan. Don't buy any property on Alderaan. Just a hunch. I think it might be a bad idea as a long-term investment. And then you've got a bunch of territories out here in the middle which are controlled by the enemy. And then separated out here in the Outer Rim, we have Bothawife, if that is indeed how it's pronounced, which is currently where Anakin and Obi-Wan are hanging out. And we've got Rishi, and we've got Kamino, which is obviously where most of the clones are produced, and indeed we get a little bit of a... If we build the cloning facility structure here, we will get a bonus sort of discount for building clone troopers here. So we want to defend this as much as we possibly can, and you can't see it properly because there's a bunch of text here in the way, but there's Shark T. A lot of these characters you'll recognize if you've watched the Clone Wars TV series, basically, but there's Shark T. She's the Jedi who basically stays on Kamino and oversees all the clone training and stuff. We have, this is probably my favorite feature of this entire mod, I'm not going to lie, we have Delta Squad from the Republic Commando game, which I did a Let's Play of on this very channel here, so you can check that out if you've not seen it, but we actually have Delta Squad as a hero unit in this game. There's a bunch of hero units you can see at the top right there, but I love the fact that they included Delta Squad in this. It's so good. We've got Fordo as well, who is an ARC trooper. We've got Commander Cody here somewhere. There he is. He's on this planet here. Commander Cody, we've got Captain Rex. We've got this bloke, Captain Dallin, who I've never heard of before. He's probably from a comic. He's probably from a comic. When in doubt, he's probably from a comic. And there's Rathana, which is where I think the majority of these new little acclimator jobbies of ours are built. The Acclimator 1 carrier loadout and the Acclimator 1 assault loadout we have access to at the moment. Those are kind of the best ships we can build. So as the campaign goes on, we will unlock other things like the Venator Star Destroyers and the Victory Star Destroyers and stuff. And possibly one of the other coolest features of this mod is the fact that Order 66, isn't it? You can choose whether or not you want to go with Order 66 and kill all the Jedi, or you can go with what's, you know, jokingly called Order 65, where you don't. You actually support the Senate and you boot out Palpatine and foil his plans, if you prefer to do that. For the purposes of this series of the Mega Campaign, we will be executing Order 66. And we will be killing all of the Jedi. Well, almost all of them anyway. For continuity's sake, right? So, yeah. I'll get that out of the way right away. We will be doing that. I believe there's even a button to do it, so I can actually be like, execute Order 66, and then click the button. It'll be very satisfying. Anyway. So, opening moves right now is going to be to basically do bugger all, because I'm just going to sit here and I'm going to let all this chunk by. The scripts run for a minute here. As this first week of the campaign goes by here. Yeah, because all sorts of things are going to pop up as we start here, so I'm just going to leave everything alone and let the game do its thing. With recent events at Geonosis, it is regrettably my duty to inform you that the Republic is at war, Commander. The clone armies have been mobilized under the leadership of the Jedi. I trust you will be able to handle the task of dealing with the threat of Count Dooku's separatists. The Republic will achieve victory if all enemy forces are removed from the galaxy. So we're going to basically control every single one of those 70-odd planets. Which is why this campaign might take a while, even though we're playing with the smallest size. So, week one's still chuntering by. You can see the progress bar down there. There's a couple of other bars we want to open up here and have a look at. There's the government tab, which has stuff like this current Senate approval rating and the current Supreme Chancellor, which is, of course, Palpatine, and I don't see that changing anytime soon in this particular campaign. I encourage you, if you're watching this at home, to go ahead, get the game. It's very cheap these days. Install the mod from the Steam Workshop and play along with me if you like. You can not execute Order 66 in your playthrough if you'd like to. Right, so yeah, basically, the planets have a certain influence level. Let me hit this button here to turn on all the relevant info. But planets have a certain influence level. There's a little bar here with a heart next to it that shows you, I think. It's not actually appearing next to all of them right now. That might update as the game tends to update scripts and stuff on a weekly basis, so right now, it says current Senate approval rating 0, but that will change as soon as week one takes by. So, yeah. The more approval rating we get, basically we unlock various bonuses and nice things happen, which is good. So we want to maintain that by maintaining high influence on our planets to stop them from rebelling against us, among other things, which is cool. It's relatively easy to keep everybody happy, though, so I'm not too worried, really. Additionally, we have resources, and this is also a new feature that's not in the vanilla game. We have ship crews, we have food supplies and industrial supplies. The short version of this is ship crews allow us to build more ships. Food supplies make sure everybody's fed, basically, and we don't have any rebellions and things. And industrial supplies are what allow us to build factories and shipyards, essentially. So that's another thing we have to keep an eye on. Our current resources, and again, that ticks over when the week goes by, so let's just sit here and wait a minute. You can also see that it's Era 2 on the side here. Current Era determines what units and structures can be built. The Empire advances in Era when their leader is killed. Oh, yeah, see, that's not actually relevant for this mod. I'll explain that later. I've just realized what that's from, but never mind. Right. This is 1.0 version of the mod, but it's still early days yet, so there's a few little glitchy bits here and there, but nothing crazy, I'm happy to say. Right, we're now at week 2, so if I go back to resources here, it should have shown us... Yes, okay, so ship crews is now up to 10. Food supplies is net... We have net food supplies of 22, expenditure of 50, and income of 72. And industrial supplies 21, which is great. We don't need to improve these for now. This will do just fine for what we're dealing with right now. Well, now first things first, I think I want to consolidate my fleets a bit. I want Cody, Rex, and this chap. Oh dear. Okay, we're about to be attacked. Let's see. The Commerce Guild's conquered Roche asteroids over there. An enemy fleet is about to invade Alderaan. Now, where would they be coming from? They're probably coming from Volpta there, aren't they? So, Alderaan currently has like a couple of Corellian corvettes defending it, and that's it. So, that's not very good. That's really not very good. All right, well. Nothing I can really do about that for now. We'll just sort of let that happen, I guess. Zoom down on this. Let's see. We want Saint Pistage here. He's Palpatine's right-hand man. He gives you a price discount for units and ships and structures and stuff. We want to put him, I think, on the ground here on Coruscant. So he's giving that bonus. And Alderaan is now being attacked. Okay, so it's a separatist fleet consisting of some of these carrier things, these droid carriers, pursuit destroyers, heavy munitions carrier, a couple of magnificent star frigates, and a Providence class carrier slash destroyer. So we're not really going to fight them here. We're going to run away. That's what we're going to do. We're going to do what Corellian corvettes do best, and that is run away. Alderaan, a peaceful utopian core world that serves as the spiritual heart of the galaxy. The people of Alderaan are immersed in high culture, education, and ecological principles that protect the planet's natural beauty. The horrors of the Clone Wars were taken to heart, and the people of Alderaan adopted pacifism, banning all weapons from the planet's surface. Yeah, we might have to overrule that ban pretty soon, because, yeah, they'll probably try a ground invasion pretty soon after this space assault here. So, our first space battle, which is not going to be much of a battle, really. It's going to be me running away. So here's our two corvettes. I'm going to send them over in this direction. And over here, the Separatist fleet. You see, they've got lots of fighters and bombers in the air already. Well, you know, air in the vacuum. You know what I mean. There is no way we can hope to defeat that fleet. Not even with the help of our starbase and our heavy frigate shipyard. Now, what we could try and do, though, ready to commence. Is with some of these free units being produced by the shipyard. What is it, sir? These two here, we can escape with. We hit the retreat button. We can call for a retreat. These guys will I almost said warp out the system. That's Star Trek. No, they'll jump to light speed and escape on the campaign map to a different planet. But all these fighters and stuff here in this dreadnought, that's being produced by the shipyard. These are all basically free units. They're expandable. We can get these things blown up if we want to. And what I kind of intend to do here really is basically just try and inflict a few casualties on the Separatists. They're going to take orbit around Alderaan, but what I'm hoping is we can maybe take down a ship of theirs in the process. Before we leg it. Actually, you know what? Two Corellian Corvettes. I'm not really too precious about these. We can easily replace those. So let's have the... Corellian Corvettes are good at two things, basically. One is running away. The other is taking on enemy fighters and bombers. They have lots of little anti-fighter lasers on them. It's kind of what they do best. So I can have them open fire on all these bombers here. And these are our Y-wings. Oh, we have an itty-bitty light assault cruiser here. I didn't even notice that. These Y-wings can attack this, what is this, auxiliary pursuit destroyer? We've knocked out its shields. The blue bar above the ship, is the shields. The green bar is their hull. It looks like we might be able to take this thing out. Dreadnought's getting a bit of a hammering, but luckily I think we'll be able to kill this first, which is very nice. Let's use this ability here called Boost Weapon Power. Drains power from the shields in order to boost the power of the lasers. Now then, can we knock anything else out? Maybe another auxiliary pursuit destroyer. Actually, let's go for this thing. Now, if I pause here, you can see that there's a bunch of subsystems all over this ship. And this is one of the things I love about this game. It kind of reminds me of playing X-Wing back in the day. Or, hell, even the old Battlefront 2 space battles. Because there's all sorts of little bits on the ships that you can individually attack, like concussion missile launcher, light turbo laser battery, the fighter bay, and the engines. And knocking out the engines, for example, it'll slow the ship down. I mean, they can't escape the hyperspace. You know, destroying their weapons is, you know, it's obvious what that does. And taking out the fighter bay means they can't launch more fighters when you've shot their existing ones down. It doesn't really matter on this particular occasion, but in future battles, it will be a good idea to actually like specify exactly which bits of the enemy ships we want to shoot at, like which bits of it we want to prioritize as targets. Let's move you guys out of harm's way a little bit for now if we can. Hopelessly outnumbered at the moment. But we have more replacements being produced here by the shipyard. They're about to destroy my little starbase here. Which, no, I'm not too sad about, honestly. Did they kill one of my Corvettes? I think they did. One of my Corvettes is sadly dead. Right, these Y-wings... Target that. Dreadnoughts, also target that. These little, what are these called? These V-19s. These are our early fighters. They look a bit like this. They're kind of peculiar looking. I remember them from the Clone Wars TV show, though. You're going to engage the enemy bombers. There we go. One of the lovely things about this game as well is you can hit the space bar to get a cinematic view of the battlefield. Works in space and in the ground battles. It's just lovely. It's wonderful. I mean, I'm not controlling my forces at the moment, so I'm fighting an awful lot less efficiently, but on the other hand, it looks really cool. So I kind of don't mind. I could also focus the camera on just one specific ship as well, if I'd like to.
What's the order? Ready to commence.
Yeah, kill this thing. You might remember these from the Phantom Menace, these. They're basically, in this game, they serve as little carriers for lots of fighters. So it wouldn't be a bad idea to kill these quickly. They don't have much health, so might as well get rid of the little buggers. Boost weapon power on that Corvette again. And we'll do it on the Dreadnought as well, because its shields are already out at this point. We might as well boost its remaining weapons. see if we can get it to wipe out this little carrier here. Oh, it's not doing any real damage to it, is it? It's because it's regenerating its shields, this thing, and all we're doing is keeping the shields down. We're not doing any damage to the hull. Because I think this thing's only got, like, 2 turbo lasers left on it, and now it's dead anyway, so... Alright. Maybe the Y-Wings can take care of it if they can get past the enemy fighter screen, which is a tall order, admittedly. But give it a go, lads. Enforcement's on me, what do we got? Something just jumped in. I heard the noise. Oh, it's another Dreadnought. Excellent. What sort of Dreadnought is it? It's just a Dreadnought heavy cruiser, okay. Yeah, the Separatists are going to desperately want to take out the shipyard here, because that'll just win in the battle straight out, basically. Alright, I think we destroyed that little carrier, so... Let's pause for a minute here and examine the stats for these guys, because they've all got, like, descriptions and stats and stuff. The game's honestly really quite in-depth, especially with the mods. Munificence, it's got a hull of 1500-ish, shields of 2000, this thing. It's actually a bit beefier, so it might be better off targeting this, because it's weaker. Targeting at maximum firepower. More likely to kill that before our... Oh dear, it's dead. Right, never mind. Right, boost weapons. I doubt we'll be able to kill this before we're wiped out, but why not give it a try? I think I've lost both of my Corvettes at this point. Yeah, they're dead. But again, they were just Corvettes. Who honestly cares? We can replace those easily. They're expendable. I don't mean to roleplay as Chancellor Palpatine, but sometimes these things just happen, alright? Oh, these poor Y-Wings. Yep, no, they're dead. Yeah, we weren't going to get that. That was a bit of a fool's hope, really. Okay, at this point... There's no real point in continuing. I could just auto-resolve to immediately end it, or just hit retreat, which will do the same thing, but... Narratively, it means at least some of the fighters will escape, and I like that, at least. Even if those were free units that we won't get back. Oh, never mind. Okay, one of the little light cruiser thingies got away. Nice. So we lost 2 Krillin Corvettes, and the Starbase and the Frigate Shipyard. They lost... a Pursuit Destroyer... 2 of those carriers and a Captor Heavy Munitions carrier. So, do you know what? For the loss of my orbital defenses and 2 Corvettes, I'll take that. That's not too bad. We dished out a bit of punishment to them there. Sippy bastards. Right, so what do we got here? An Aquitans light cruiser. Over Trandrilla, we've got another Corvette. Where is the big fleet? Where's the good stuff at? An acclimated one here. We've got Adar Talon, who is a fighter commander. Celebrity officer famous before the Clone Wars started thanks to authoring... the treatise on starfighter tactics, which heavily influenced the design for the Republic's TIE starfighter. Given command during the war, he eventually became known as a father of the Republic Navy. Okay, so he commands an acclimated, the Sun Diver. And, he's basically a super awesome commander hero guy. And I believe, I suspect, he probably deployed a squadron of really, really good pilots or something. If I had to guess. So let's get him. Let's get... I don't want a Jedi in a space battle. They're not very helpful in space battles, Jedi. They die very quickly. And once they're dead, they're gone. In the vanilla game, heroes respawned, but in this mod... Once they're dead, they're dead. If I accidentally get Anakin squashed by a spider droid, he's just dead. So I'm going to have to try very hard to try and preserve my heroes in this campaign and not get them killed in really stupid ways. Because believe me, I'm very good at getting heroes killed in very stupid ways in this game. Let's take this main fleet from Coruscant. up to Anaxes and then try and rush over to Alderaan before the invasion force arrives. But I doubt we'll manage that. They're probably already sending transports full of battle droids on their way right now. Unfortunately, who's this over here? Who we got? We got Captain Peleon. I remember him from the he's in the old Thrawn novels, I think, isn't he? Okay, there's a bunch of stuff here too. Tell you what, we'll drag you guys away as well. Let's move this Corvette there. Let's move Peleon out there as well. And this is the Larquitons as well. Get everybody grouped up around Anaxes. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Now, there's one thing we want to do here. There's a little slot here on each of these fleet slots here. This little blue thing. That, if we drag a unit into there, basically what that will do is if I put this Corvette in there, what will happen when the battle begins and we're attacking is that the Corvette will jump in from light speed first. It'll jump out of hyperspace first by itself. And then, when it's jumped in, we can drag in any of these units from hyperspace as we see fit in the locations we want. So rather than just deploying a whole bunch of ships right at the start, what you really want to do is send in a Pathfinder, a sort of scout ship, to get the lay of the land before deciding where you want to bring your own ships in. So we've set that Corvette to be the sort of Pathfinder scout, if you like, ahead of the main force. And then I think we'll bring it over to Alderaan. Now, let me just have a little butchers down here at this corner of the galaxy. Do we also control Mon Calamari? We do, actually, yeah. We have this that all by itself up in the corner there. I don't know how long we're actually going to be able to keep that for, honestly, because it's pretty much surrounded, but hey. Down here in Kamino, Outer Rim land, what do we got? We got a bunch of ships around Rathana. We have Shakti. Why are you in space? We should really have you on the ground. You know what we want to do? We want to. Let's see. Let's take some of these clone commandos, put them in space. We'll put Shakti on the ground. There we go. Put you guys into a separate fleet slot. There we go. And what we'll do is actually do the same with these two as well, Fordo and Delta Squad. Let's put them in a separate slot. Right. We need to get our clone army together, basically. We've got Ryloth over here, cut off completely from everything else at the moment. We've got Tatooine and Geonosis standing between us and Ryloth at the moment. I'd like to take Tatooine and Geonosis straight away, really, to free up Ryloth. Although, we could go for Hyporia instead and then Geonosis. But Tatooine will be easier to take. You can see here the little gun turrets are the ground base level and the shields are the orbital strength. And Hyporia is much better defended than Tatooine is. So probably easier to go for Tatooine first. But we're going to need to get an army together. So let's get Rex and Cody, my dudes. Let's get you guys into space. Who's this chap here? Captain Dallin. Commands a modified Dreadnought heavy cruiser. Okay, cool beans. Let's drag you guys over here to the same slot as Delta Squad. And let's hop back over to the core now and take out these guys if we can, if we have time. I should have done that earlier, but hey. Ah, damn it. If I hadn't been farting around down here, we probably could have intercepted them in time. All right, so our first ground battle as we defend Alderaan with what we've got on the surface right now is one unit of Defense Force troopers. So these aren't even clones; these are just sort of the pre-Clone Wars Republic like volunteer defense corps or whatever. They're not very good, and we've got some AT-PT walkers against. Oh dear, let's see. We've got AAT tanks. We got those tank droid things. Snail tanks. We've got Sora Bulk, whoever that is. Some sort of force user. We've got Dooku himself. Christopher Lee is in fact leading the assault personally. That's a scary thought. A B1 Battle Droid Platoon. Some STAP companies, which are the weird hover jet bike things. And Hailfire Droids as well. What we have is a few garrison units from our Senator's office. And from our barracks here. Let's see if we can make a decent job of this. We might be able to repel the assault. We'll see. I'm not very optimistic, but we'll give it a good go. You know, for a bunch of pacifists, there's an awful lot of troops garrisoned on Alderaan now that I think about it, but okay, fine. A peaceful utopian core world that says that, yeah, we've already read that, actually. I should just get on with it. Okay, so let's have a little look at the map here. We've got our sort of base area over here with the buildings, and unlike in sort of, you know, your traditional Command and Conquer style game, we don't build things from the buildings. They will just produce reinforcements automatically as our troops get taken out in battle. Please pay no attention to the Empire logo on the side of that building. let's see. There's a few little artifacts of the vanilla game showing through here and there. Occasionally. Right, so what have we got here? We got a couple of Saber tanks, which... speaking of things from the original game showing through... yeah, pay no attention to the fact that those are Imperial Stormtroopers on the turrets. Oops. Anyway, here's the actual clones. Here we go. They're Phase 1 clones, so they've got those sort of Mandalorian-style helmets, which I rather like. These are diplomatic service troopers with the red flashes on them. Yeah. Otherwise, standard clones that serve as guards for diplomatic and government buildings, as well as providing security for government-level ventures and events. No specific training compared to other clones or the later shock troopers that succeed them. Yeah. We've got dude on a bike. We've got ATPT walkers, the all-terrain personal transport, in fact. And we've got clone troopers, and around here somewhere is our defense guys. Somewhere. Where are they? There they are. Defense force troopers. Not really going to rely on them for anything. They are not very good. Now, as we look over the map here, we've got these things here. These are sort of objective points. They're reinforcement points. If you capture them, you can bring in your troops from orbit there as a spawn point, basically. The Separatists start off with a spawn point down here, but there's one they can capture there and one they can capture there. What I might do is send these Defense Force troopers over there to grab that, just to deny it to the enemy for a little while. And these bits down here we've got are areas where we can build defense turrets, and there's a bunker we can occupy as well. So really what we want to do is just take everybody here and head down that way. Now the battles in this mod are quite fast-paced, so I might have to pause quite a lot occasionally. Normally I'd be fine, but I'm trying to do the whole commentary and playing the game thing at the same time, which even after like 10 years of doing this thing on YouTube, I've still never really gotten very good at. So you capture these and they turn red, and then we can build turrets on them. I'm building an infantry turret there and an anti-vehicle turret on that one. Let's get a bunch of you guys into that bunker. Let's get the scout bikes back here. I'm going to hotkey you guys to group 4 because you might be useful later. The thing about them is they can zoom on in and drop a bunch of explosive charges, which will explode like a few seconds later. So it can be a good idea to micromanage those guys for the best results. And I would love for the Saber tank to actually turn around so it's facing the enemy, but he's been really stubborn about it. There we go. All right, here they come. Oh, hello. Right. There's a thing we can do here. If we capture these points, we can actually build a little bunkery thing on it, which will produce reinforcements. Let's build a military field base. Let's put all of you guys in take cover modes. They move slower, but they take less damage. Those were some destroyers there, some droidicas. Yeah, there's one. You can just see him. With his little bubble shield around him. Right. Ah, I've just had an idea. You guys, run up here and capture those turret positions. Right, what have we got coming at us right now? We got the bike, jet bike guys, we got a tank droid, we got these wheelie droid things. I'm going to be calling them really silly names like wheelie droids a lot, honestly, because I can't remember the proper names for them. Oh, is this the... What on earth? He was headless there for a second. This is Sora Bulk, former Weequay Jedi Master who now serves as Dooku's head Dark Acolyte. Renowned among the Jedi for his skill with a lightsaber, he mastered every form of lightsaber combat known among the Jedi, becoming one of their greatest instructors and weapon masters, and assisted with the Vapad form, which influenced his studies with darkness and eventually pushed him into Dooku's grasp. Okay. Jedi, yeah. They're quite powerful in this game, but you do have to micromanage them a bit to really get the most out of them. My worry is that we're going to end up getting Dooku killed in this first battle. There he is. Speak of the devil. Count Dooku. Born as nobility on Sereno, a Jedi master who left the Order due to misgivings and became a political activist and member of the Sith. Leveraged his wealth and status to assist the formation of the Separatist Crisis. There he is. There's the man himself. And my worry here is we're going to end up killing Count Dooku in the first land battle of the campaign. That could totally happen. Because the AI isn't super clever with what with how they deploy their heroes in this game, unfortunately. Ooh, yeah, we got it. Right, see, these wheelie droid things, they are very fragile. They kick out a lot of damage with those rockets of theirs, but they are quite fragile. They will die pretty fast. Right, I've taken out both my saber tanks now. That's not very nice of them, all things considered. How are things going over here? Ah, they... Right, you can run over enemy troops just like that with your tanks in this. Command and conquer style. You might remember that back in the day. It's an irritating feature, honestly, because I have to micromanage very closely to avoid my dudes all getting run over, and I'm not very good at micromanaging, really, so... Right, let's use the you guys to try and blow this up with a bomb. Well, multiple bombs, really. Off you go. Kaboom. Brilliant. That probably wasn't the best use ever, really, of one of those, but we'll take it. Right, we've got a few reinforcements. Let's bring you guys down here. How's it going up here? Still managing to hold the line, although you're getting all chopped up by this Sora Bulk character here. And Dooku. Both of them are just going to town on all my little clone troopers. Oh dear. Okay, everyone here's dead. How did that happen? Did you all get run over or something? I bet you did, didn't you? Just like that. Alright, all I've got now is a bunch of jet bikers. Okay. Well, I was optimistic. Well, I wasn't really optimistic. I entertained the hope of maybe actually being able to hold this planet. But it's not going very well. I might have been able to do better if I wasn't distracted by talking, honestly, but hey ho. Let's deploy some bombs and run away. Run away. Run away. I killed a few droids there. Oh god, here come the Sith. Kill Dooku. Actually, don't kill Dooku. I don't want Dooku to die in the... Oh, he's going to die, isn't he? Sell the infantry turret. No, we can't kill Dooku in the first campaign mission. That would be really silly. Let's not do that. I'd rather let them take the planet than just kill Dooku in episode one of the fucking campaign. Just kill the droids. Kill the droids. Ignore the droids. Actually, no, we can kill this dude, this second-rate Z-list villain over here. I don't mind killing him. That's fine. We can kill him all you like. Just don't kill Dooku! It distresses me how low Dooku's health is right now. Like I said, the AI does not micromanage its heroes very well. Because the problem is, in the vanilla game, heroes respawn after they die. So the AI hasn't really been... programmed to treat its heroes with any caution whatsoever, which is honestly, like, I love this mod, but I would honestly prefer it if heroes respawned, because for the reason I've just mentioned, basically, because the AI doesn't know how to be careful with them. Now, I could be wrong. I'm still relatively new to this mod. I don't understand quite all the features. It could be the case that actually the enemy heroes do respawn. It's just my heroes that don't respawn. And that I would be okay with. I'm fine with getting my own heroes killed through my own negligence. I just don't want the leader of the Separatist Alliance to die to a bunch of clone troopers in episode one. Because that would be rather silly. In fact, honestly, I think I'm just gonna... Let's go ahead and retreat. Now, ordinarily, actually, if we had some troops left, we could move them to a deployment zone thing here and escape the planet. Sort of Empire Strikes Back style. But we had no one left on this occasion, so they've taken Alderaan. We're off to a fine start today. Right. Okay, so, let's see. The fleet just could not get there quite in time, thanks to my own faffing about. Oops. Right, we'll take back Alderaan pretty swiftly. I think that's probably going to be our first order of business as the campaign opens up, folks. But I'm actually going to have to call it for this episode here, because I've just looked at the clock. And with the intro on top of this, that will bring us to almost an hour, I think, probably at this point. So, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I hope you enjoyed watching this intro to the Empire at War mega campaign. I hope you decide to stick around for the rest of it. If not, that's fine. But I hope you do. I hope you enjoy this as much as I'm enjoying playing this. And I will see you next time. I do not shill for my Patreon very often, but I'm going to on this particular occasion because it's the first episode of a new series. And also, because of all the Star Wars music in this video, you can pretty much guarantee that I won't be able to monetize this at all. That my chances of monetizing this video are about the same as a Stormtrooper's chances of actually hitting his target. Let's put it that way. But I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. I like having the Star Wars music in it and stuff. So I'm prepared to put up with the demonetization just for the sake of playing this really cool game. So, ladies and gents, boys and girls, thank you very much for watching. I will catch you in episode 2 of this series very, very soon. Have a good one.